Good morning. Myself, Dr. Rashmi Sharma, Associate Professor, Zoology, SPC-GCA. Today we will take interspecific and intraspecific relationship in ecology, BSc Part 3. Interspecific relationship are relationship between the members of same species. An interspecific relationship is relationship between the members of two different species. Interspecific relationship number one is mutualism. Species A and species B, two species are present. They are living in an ecosystem and both of them, they are neutral for each other, means neither beneficial nor harmful. Second is symbiosis. In symbiosis, both species A and species B are beneficial for each other. They are living in an ecosystem and they are beneficial for each other. Next is commensalism. Commensalism means eating on same table. Both species are living in an ecosystem and they are beneficial for each other, but the relationship is not necessary for each other, means they can live without each other. Commensalism with continuous contact and commensalism without continuous contact. Two type of commensalisms are there. Example is Opelina living in the alimentary canal of frog, E. coli living in the alimentary canal of human being. Endocommensalism and ectocommensalism. Commensalism are again of two types. Endocommensalism, when animal is living inside the other inside the body of other animal. Endocommensalism, one species B is living inside the body of species A. Ectocommensalism, when species A is living on the body of species B. This is ectocommensalism. Ecto means outside and endo means inside. Infilism is when two animals share the same tunnel. This is known as infilism. Echinus or remora fish or sucker fish attaches from the ventral side of the body of big fish and they suck nutrition from the big fish. This is ectocommensalism. Phaeacetal fish lives in the cloaca of sea cucumber. It gets protection there in the cloaca of sea cucumber. This is endocommensalism. Staphylinidae beetle lives in the tunnel of termite. This is beneficial for beetle. It gets protection in the tunnel of termite. Polynox live in the tunnel of Chaetoptera. Like this, crab scleroplax live in the tunnel of Callionessa shrimp. This type of relationship is relationship. Barnacles live on the body of big whales. Barnacles get protection and shelter on the body of whales and whales are not affected by this type of relationship. Hermit crab, Eupagerus praedosi, live in the empty shell of snail. Hermit crab, Eupagerus get protection in the empty shell of snail. Adamsia lives on the shell of snail. It gets movement when the snail moves and also get protection. Clownfish, Amphibian Xanthurus lives in the tentacles of sea anemone and by this clownfish gets protection. Epizoans and epiphytes. Epizoans are animals, small animals living on the outer surface of big animals and epiphytes are small plants that live on the outer surface of big plants. They get shelter, both epizoan and epiphyte get shelter there. Green algae lives on the hair of sloth bear. Sloth bear is not affected by this type of relationship and green algae gets protection and shelter there. Members of family bromeliaceae grow on big tree. They get shelter and protection there. They have velamen tissue which absorb humidity and nutrition from big plants. Likewise, cattle aigrette follow cattles and they get nutrition by the insects, mites and ticks on the body of cattle and protection, and other species is not affected by this kind of relationship. Monkeys live on trees, and below those trees deer live and they get food from the droppings of monkeys. Now comes mutualism. Number one example of mutualism, when species A and species B both living together and both are beneficial from each other. They get benefit from each other. Example, lichens. Algae and fungus live together. Algae synthesize food which is taken by fungus, and in turn algae receives nutrition and humidity from the fungus. Examples are Graphis, Paramelia, Cladonia. These are all examples of lichens. Nitrogen fixing bacteria, Rhizobium radicicola, lives in the root nodules of Pisum plant. They fix nitrogen for the plant, and in turn they get humidity and nutrition from the plant. Likewise, termite and wood roaches. Termites eat cellulose which is not digested by the alimentary canal of termite, but protozoon Mixotrichum paradoxi is present in their alimentary canal which changes cellulose into glucose. Ruminant microbes are present in ruminants which convert cellulose into glucose. Nomous fish lives in the tentacles of Physalia. They get protection there, and Physalia in turn get prey which are attracted to nomous fish. Dairy ant and care aphid are another example of mutualism. Dairy ant care for aphid, and in turn they get sugar lump and honeydew from those aphids. Ectotrophic and endotrophic fungus hyphae are present which live on big plants, and they get nutrition and humidity from those. African acacia, also known as bullhorn acacia or Vachellia cornigera. In this African acacia, Belgian bodies are present which have protein and sugar. Ants also live on these. They get nutrition from these bodies, and in turn the acacia get protection from ants. Green algae live on sea anemone, jellyfish, corals. Chlorella algae on Paramecium bursera. This type of relationship is also beneficial for both of the species. Zoochlorella and Zooxanthella are present on the body of Hydra. This type of relationship is also beneficial. Yucca moth present on yucca plant. They pollinate the yucca plant, and in turn this get protection and food from the plant. This type of relationship is beneficial for both of them. Protocooperation is also beneficiary type of relationship. Species A and B both are getting benefit, but this is not necessary for each other. Sea anemone, Adensia palliata and hermit crab living together, both getting benefit from each other. Cleaner fish living on the body of big fish eat fungus from the big fish, and the big fish get their body get cleaned up. Tick bird, warthog, oxpecker, black drongo, tree pie, they eat tick from the animals on which they live, and the animals get rid from the ticks. Antagonistic type of symbiosis. Antagonistic type of symbiosis, one animal is harmed and another neutral or beneficial. First type of relationship is parasitism. Parasitism, small animal lives in the body of large animal. The large animal in which the small animal lives as parasite get harmed because disease are caused in large animals. Examples are facultative parasites, also known as vikalpi parasite, obligate parasite, avikalpi parasite. Plasmodium, tinea, fasciola are example of obligate parasite. Ectoparasite, bedbug, cymex, pediculus, humanus, hirudinaria, sanguivorus, nematode, these are all example of ectoparasite. Cuscuta, amarbale is also example of ectoparasite. Orobank, balanophore, striga are parasite on the roots of brinjal. They get nutrition from the roots of brinjal. Rust and smuts are also in the category of parasite. Monogenetic parasite and digenetic parasite, two type of parasites are there. When parasite completing its life cycle in one host, it is known as monogenetic, and when it is completing in two hosts, it is known as digenetic. One is also known as reservoir of host, means it does not show symptoms of the disease. Vector, primary host. Primary host is the host in which the parasite completes its sexual reproduction cycle. And secondary host in which it completes its asexual reproductive cycle and it lives, grows and takes nutrition from its body. Erratic host or aberrant host are also present. They are abnormal host. In abnormal condition they become host. They are also known as asamanya host. Periodic or sporadic host are also present. Complete parasite, partial parasite. Example are technid fly, ichneumonid fly, praconid fly, calcid fly, in which larva lives as parasite is known as parasitoid. Locidium larva of apple snail is also parasite and the adult form is free living. Now comes hyperparasitism is when parasite itself lives in the body of parasite, then it is known as hyperparasite. Nosema is the example of hyperparasite. Brood parasite is when Eudenimus or cuckoo, Scolopatia and Corvus splendens, this cuckoo gives its egg in the nest of Corvus splendens and Corvus splendens take care of those eggs. That is why it is known as brood parasite. Pied or crested cuckoo and babblers are also example of brood parasite. Sexual parasitism, Bonania, male is smaller than female and it lives inside the body of female, is known as sexual parasitism. Predation. Predation, when large animal eats a small animal, it is known as predation. Example, in plants, predation is also there. Bladderwort, Utricularia, pitcher plant, Nepenthes, Sundew, Drosera, fungus, Dactylella, Dactylaria, Art Hydrobotrys, Zoophagus are also example of predation. Antibiosis. Chlorella vulgaris secretes bactericides which stop growth of other plants and animals around those areas in which it lives. It also stops the growth of Daphnia. Microcystis bloom secretes hydroxylamine toxic substance which destroys fishes and cattle of that area. Barley, Hordeum vulgare, also stops growth of other plants in the ecosystem in which barley grows. It also decreases weeds in those areas. Then is vegetable which grow in South America. This is also the type of vegetation which stopped growth of other plants. Oklahoma grass, also known as Aristida grass, Oleaganthus grass, secrete phenolic acid which stop growth of nitrogen fixing bacteria. Aristida need low nitrogen, that is why it is antagonistic species. Now come competition. Competition is a type of relationship in which species A competes with species B and both are harmful for each other. They compete for food, they compete for shelter and habitat. Functional habitat is nick in which one species lives and it stops the growth of other species. Two species cannot share the same nick. This principle is given by Gauss in 1934. Competition leads to exploitation, migratory on immigration. It also causes migration and immigration. Thank you.